Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed the important part of the alimentary canal, that is the small intestine. Today we will discuss two main important remaining part of the alimentary canal. Those are the large intestine and the anus. First we will discuss the large intestine. First point, it is a tube-like structure having variable diameter and its length is around 1.5 meter. It is a tube-like structure having variable diameter . Its length is around 1.5 meter. बुझ पाले? अच्छा important point जो हमें टिके mark करिवा, why it is called large intestine? याको हमें large intestine बोली कहीं कोई ले? तार तो लेंथ होची कते 1.5 meter बहुत कम अच्छे एज कंपेयर टू द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. ताहले याको हमें कहें कि कहिले जे इट इज द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन बिकॉज इट्स डायमीटर इज समहाउ ग्रेटर देन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. दिस इज व्हाई और दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. एज द डायमीटर of large intestine is greater than the small intestine, it is so called. बुझले? जेहेतु लेंथ कम ही पारे कते 1.5 मीटर किंतु आपण को जेहेतु डायमीटर स्मॉल लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन रो अधिक एज द डायमीटर इज मच मोर ग्रेटर एज कंपेयर टू द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नोन एज लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. दुटा जनरल पॉइंट जानले, इट इज ए ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर हैविंग वेरिएबल डायमीटर, लेंथ इज अराउंड 1.5 मीटर. As the diameter of the large intestine is greater than the small intestine, that is why the large intestine is so called. As the diameter of large intestine is greater than the small intestine, it is so called. Mujhe palle? Next point. Large intestine also consists of three main parts. Mujhe palle? Cecum, colon, and rectum. It consists of cecum, colon, and rectum. The three important parts of the large intestine are your cecum, colon, and rectum. Tinta ko ame detail re padhiba. Cecum kon, colon kon, rectum kon. Bujhi parle? First, we'll discuss cecum. First point, the length of cecum is somehow 6 cm and breadth is somehow about 7.5 cm and it is a pouch-like structure. It is a pouch like structure having 6 cm in length and 7.5 cm breadth, or we can say width. बुझ पाले? Next point. The cecum, from the cecum region arises a blind tube called vermiform appendix. A blind tube arises from cecum known as vermiform appendix. बुझ पाले? गोटे portion present अच्छे हमारो which arises, or a tube like structure which arises from the cecum region which is known as vermiform appendix and its length is around 8 cm, having length around 8 cm. बुझ पाले? तीन टा मेन जिनसे देखो, सिकम रो लेंथ केते आसिला 6 cm, विड्थ केते 7.5 cm, सेठू आपनकर वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स आसिला एराइज हला, तार लेंथ केते 8 cm. बुझ पाले? बट द वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स इज वेस्टिजियल इन केस ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग. Vermiform appendix is vestigial in case of human being. Vestigial माने कौन? जोटा के आगे दरकार होता है पारे बहुत वर्ष पूर्व कि सेंचुरीज पूर्व आम दरकार होता कि दरकार हो जोटा कि गोटे अनवांटेड गोटे पोर्शन कि पार्ट हिसाब से आम बॉडी रे प्रेजेंट अच्छे, दैट इज नोन एज वेस्टिजियल पार्ट. वेस्टिजियल मान कौन? व्हिच इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन आवर बॉडी. सो द वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स इज द वेस्टिजियल पार्ट, इज द वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स इज द वेस्टिजियल पार्ट इन केस ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग. Vestigial part. Vestigial part in case of human being. It have no importance in case of human being, but if the food get accumulated in the vermiform appendix, it's get infected. बुझ पाले? यार इम्पोर्टेन्स किसी ना, बट जदि फूड जहाँकि आम खाई कि डाइजेशन प्रोसेस कंटिन्यू होता है, जब अधिक रू अधिक एक्युमुलेशन हो जाए कि स्टोर हो रही जाए तो सी कौन कर इनफेक्शन करनी. ताले द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज द एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ डिकेइंग फूड व्हिच कॉजेस द infection or the inflammation of the vermiform appendix. Accumulation of food, or we can say decaying food, causes inflammation of vermiform appendix. जहाँकि आम इज नॉर्मली कही था appendicitis रोग बोली. वर्मीफॉर्म रो अपेंडिक्स रो काम कि ना, बट जदि फूड स्टोर हो रही जाए कि एक्युमुलेट हो जाए तो सी कौन कर इनफेक्शन करनब, जोटा कि आम बॉडी पे माने हार्मफुल. केमती? जदि फुड गुड़ाक अधिकर अधिका ता भितर स्टोर होइक रहिगला डिके हेबाक लागिला से कोन करिवो धीरे धीरे से वर्मी फॉर्म को पूरा इन्फेक्शन पूरा इन्फेक्टेड करन जहाँ द्वारा से धीरे धीरे स्वेलिंग होइक ना ब्रस्ट होइजो जहाँद्वारा कि से ब्रस्ट तो हम जहाँ भितर तार इन्फेक्टेड पार्ट थी से गुड़ाक चारिआडे खेली जीव जहाँद्वारा कि से अदर सेगमेंट्स को भी से इन्फेक्टेड करन से द रिमूवल ऑफ द इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ द वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स इज नोन एज अपेंडेक्टोमी द रिमूवल ऑफ द इन्फ्लेमेटेड और द इन्फेक्टेड वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स इज नोन एज अपेंडेक्टोमी द रिमूवल ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स is known as appendectomy bujhi parle vermiform appendix is an vestigial organ that is present in the human being it have no importance in case of human being but it can cause infection due to accumulation of the food or the decaying food by which at last it can swell and burst by spreading the infected part of the vermiform appendix so the surgical removal of the infected vermiform appendix is known as appendectomy eta bhi apan gote objective asi pare acha aw dita point the vermiform appendix has an important role in case of herbivores such as horse rabbit which helps in digesting the cellulose vermiform appendix plays important role in case of herbivores such as rabbit horse etc which helps in digesting it helps in digestion of cellulose bujh palle वर्मीफॉर्म अपेंडिक्स रो इम्पोर्टेंस इट हैज एन इट प्लेज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन केस ऑफ हर्बीवोर्स और वी कैन से माने जमती कि हॉर्स हो किंबा रैबिट हो व्हिच हेल्प्स इन द डाइजेशन ऑफ द सेलुलोज सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर सिकम रीजन नेक्स्ट वील डिस्कस द सेकेंड पार्ट दैट इज द कोलोन colon second point the colon is the middle part of the large intestine and it lies between the cecum and the rectum it is the middle part of the large intestine and lies in between the cecum and rectum. Next point. It is the middle part of the large intestine and it lies in between the cecum and the rectum. Second point, it is the largest part of the large intestine. Bujhbarle? Next point, colon is being divided into four main parts: ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon and the sigmoid colon. Ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, last is your sigmoid colon. First is your ascending colon. The length of the ascending colon is around 15 cm and it is present on the right side of your abdominal cavity and it's run along upside in the vertical, mane in vertical way, mane ei bhaliya jibo, ei bhaliya present apanakar achi upward mane lower portion ro apanko upper portion ro asibo on the right side of the abdominal cavity. So we can say its length is 15 cm present on the left side, sorry, on the right side, on the right side of abdominal cavity, which is vertical in position. Bujhipalle? So the ascending colon's length is around 15 cm, is around 15 cm, which is present on the right side of the abdominal cavity and it is vertically located and it's run from the lower portion to your upward portion. Next is the transverse colon. Its length is around 50 cm and it runs transverse. Mane ei portion ta asila apanagar descending, this one is your transverse, means it runs from the right side to the left side of the abdominal cavity and it runs transversely and its length is about 50 cm. Its length is 50 cm and runs transversely from right side to left side of abdominal cavity. Bujhipale? It is the transverse. Mu sabule koichi transverse mane hochi ei section. So its length is around 50 cm which runs transversely from right side to left side of abdominal cavity. This is your abdominal cavity, means this one is your ascending colon, this one is your transverse colon, which runs from the right side to the left side of the abdominal cavity and its length is around 50 cm. Next colon is your descending colon. The length of the descending colon is somewhat 25 cm and it runs from the in the left side of the abdominal cavity from the upward direction to the downward direction. Its length is 25 cm present on the left side of abdominal cavity. This is also vertically located. बुझ पाले? This one is your ascending means in the upward direction. This one vertical in the downward direction. बुझ पाले? Descending, ascending means upward, descending means lowerward. So the descending colon, its length is around 25 cm, present on the left side of the abdominal cavity, vertical located, and its flow and its direction is from upward to the lower direction. Last colon is your sigmoid colon. Its length is around 40 cm, and it is so called sigmoid colon because its shape is somehow S-shaped. Its length is 40 cm and is S-shaped, and situated in pelvic region, also called pelvic colon. So the last colon is your sigmoid colon. Sigmoid means S-shaped. As the shape and structure of the sigmoid colon is S-shaped, it is that's why called the sigmoid colon, and its length is around 40 cm. As it is present in the pelvic region, it is also known as the pelvic colon. Its length is 40 cm and is S-shaped and situated in the pelvic region, also called the pelvic colon. So next we'll discuss the last part, that is called the rectum. This is all about your colon. It is the middle part of the large intestine and lies in the cecum and rectum. Colon is divided into four main parts: ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon. Ascending colon, its length is around 15 cm, and it is vertically located on the right side of the abdominal cavity, and its direction from the upward to from the lower portion to the upward direction. Then the transverse colon, its length is about 50 cm, and it's run transversely from the right side of the abdominal cavity into the left side of the abdominal cavity. And the third one is your descending colon. Its length is around 25 cm, and its direction is from the upward direction to the lowerward direction. It is also located in the vertical located in the left side of the abdominal cavity. Last point is your sigmoid colon. It is sigmoid colon so called because due to the structure is somehow S-shaped, and also it is present in the pelvic region, so it is also called the pelvic colon, and its length is about 40 cm. Now we'll discuss the last part of the large intestine, that is the rectum. Rectum. It is the distal part or the last part of the large intestine, having length around 15 cm, and it leads to the anus by an anal opening having a length around 2.5 cm. First point, it is the distal part of large intestine, सेकेंड पॉइंट डिस्टल पने लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. सेकेंड पॉइंट इट्स लेंथ इज अराउंड 15 cm हैविंग एंड इट लीड्स टू अन एनस टू द एनस बाय एन ओपनिंग कॉल्ड एनल ओपनिंग विच इज विच लेंथ इज अराउंड 2.5 cm. Its length is around 15 cm, which leads to the anus by an anal opening. Having length around 2.5 cm. बुझ पाले? Next point. तले rectum, it is the distal part of the large intestine. And its length is around 15 cm, which leads to the anus by an anal opening having length around 2.5 cm. अच्छा, लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन में हम तीन टा पोर्शन देखिले. वन इज द सिकमरिजम, देन इज योर कोलन, देन इज योर रेक्टम. अनदर वन इम्पोर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ कोलन, दैट इज इट प्रेजेंस ऑफ वेरियस मॉस्कुलर कॉर्ड्स विच हेल्प्स इन सेगमेंटेशन ऑफ द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन बाय क्रिएटिंग सम पाउचेस लाइक स्ट्रक्चर कॉल्ड होस्ट्रा. ये गोटे इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट मन रखु. यहाँ कोलन अंडर आसव, ये जेनराल पॉइंट आम लिखा. यहाँ रेक्टम सरला पॉइंट, जेनराल पॉइंट मुझे लिखुच्छे. आप गोटे इम्पोर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स अच्छे आपणकर कोलोन केस रे. कोलोन कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए मस्कुलर कॉर्ड व्हिच हेल्प्स इन गिविंग पाउच लाइक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द टू द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन व्हिच इज कॉल्ड द होस्ट्रा. आप लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन स्ट्रक्चर देखिए किटा ए भलिया थाए, बुझि पड़ले? से भितरे गोटे लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल मस्कुलर कॉर्ड गोटे फ्लो होइछि. The presence of this muscular cord helps, which when contracts, helps in the formation of various pouch-like segment in the colon region, which are known as hostra. बुझ पाले? लिखी दूँ तुझे. Colon रो पॉइंट है. Colon consists of muscular cord which when contracts to form the pouch like segmental structure of the colon region of large intestine called hostra. बुझ पाले? So the important characteristics, one of the important more characteristics of the colon is the colon consists of muscular cord. मतलब ये भाई सेगमेंट अच्छे से कंट्राक्ट हे से कौन कर पूरा सेगमेंट को किसीटा पोर्सन भाया पाउच भाया फर्मेसन करनाब जमीक ये गोटे गोटे सेगमेंट को आम हस्ट्रा बोली कह. कोलन कंसिस्ट ऑफ मस्कुलर कॉर्ड व्हिच व्हेन कंट्रैक्ट्स टू फॉर्म द पाउच लाइक सेगमेंटल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द कोलन रीजन ऑफ लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन कॉल्ड हस्ट्रा. बुझिपारे? नेक्स्ट द फंक्शंस ऑफ द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. There are three main functions of large intestine. First one, large intestine helps in the absorption of water. जितेबेले आपनको डाइजेशन प्रक्रियाटा चली थाए से डाइजेशन जितेबेले हेई थाए से कोन करथाय जते अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर थाए ताको एब्जॉर्ब करिवारे हेल्प करे कहिना आवर बॉडी वी नो मेजरली कंसिस्ट ऑफ वाटर सो जति के अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर को से एक्सट्रैक्ट करि परबो किबे एब्जॉर्ब करि परबो लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन सेटा इंपोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करे सेही काम करिवारे ओटा इट फर्स्टली इट हेल्प्स इन द इट प्लेस एन इंपोर्टेंट रोल इन द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ द वाटर सो वी कैन से फर्स्ट पॉइंट It helps in absorption of water. Second point, it helps in formation, temporary storage, and elimination of fecal matter. Mane, we can say undigested food particles that we eliminate by the process of egestion. It occur due to large intestine. The main role of the function of the large intestine is to it helps in formation, temporary storage, and elimination of fecal matters. It helps in formation, temporary storage. And elimination of fecal matters, or we can also say undigested food particles. Which releases in the form of stool. So, it helps in the formation, ताको तैयारी करिवारे, temporary storage, जो पंदो जाए आमें eliminate कर देने, से ताको temporary storage रखिवारे, से help करे, and elimination, eliminate करिवारे, से help करे. It helps in formation, temporary storage, and the elimination of the fecal matters. Last point, the colon bacteria that are present in the case of colon, which helps in producing the various vitamins such as B12 and vitamin K, which are also very important, and these are also absorbed. Last point, colon bacteria produces vitamin B12 and K, which are also absorbed. Bujhi parle? So colon bacteria produces vitamin B12 and vitamin K, which are also absorbed, which are very important for our body. So this is all about your large intestine. Briefly, mu first kahi debi. Large intestine is the length is around 1.5 meter. But it is so called the large intestine because due to the variable diameter, or we can say its diameter is much more greater than in case of the small intestine. Its length may be smaller, but its diameter is somehow greater in case of as compared to the small intestine. So it is called as large intestine. Large intestine is further divided or consists of three main parts: cecum, colon, and rectum. Cecum is a pouch-like structure having length around 6 cm and width around 7.5 cm. From the cecum arises a blind tube-like structure called vermiform appendix having length around 8 cm. Then the vermiform appendix is no use in case of human being, or we can say it is vestigial organ. Vestigial organ means एटा केस रे दरकार बिल्कुल नो. Vestigial माने आगो पूर्वपुरुष केस रे माने बहुत रे दरकार थिला. इन द सेंचुरीज बैक it may be required, but in now case it is not required. So it is, we can say the vestigial organ means it have no use in case of human body. Next point, but it is of no use, it is also vestigial organ, but it can cause inflammation or infection due to accumulation of decaying food in the vermiform appendix.
by which it can finally swell up and burst, and by dispersing the infected food particles, which causes the disease called appendicitis. And the removal of this appendicitis or the infected vermiform appendix is known as appendectomy. It is a surgical method of the removal of the infected vermiform appendix. As it is not required, we can easily remove it. But the vermiform appendix is highly important in case of the herbivore organisms or animals, which such as the example as horse, rabbit, etc., which helps in digestion of the cellulose. Next, the portion is your colon portion. Colon is the largest part of the large intestine, and it is divided into four parts. Those are the ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and the sigmoid colon. The colon consists of a string-like structure called the muscular cord, which when contracts make the large intestine as a pouch-like segment called hostra. The colons are as of four types: ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and the sigmoid colon. Ascending colon, its length is around 15 cm, and it's run vertically from in the right side of the abdominal cavity, and it's run from the lower portion to the upper portion. Then the transverse colon, its length is around 50 cm, and it runs transversely from the right side of the abdominal cavity into the left side of the abdominal cavity. Then the descending colon is present in the left side of the abdominal cavity. It also vertically located, and it's run, and its length is around 25 cm, and it runs from the upward direction to the lower direction. Last is the sigmoid colon, which is so called because due to the shape of the colon, that is S-shaped, and also it is present in the pelvic region, so it is known as the pelvic colon, and its length is about 40 cm. Next point, the function of the, sorry, the rectum. Last point is the rectum. Rectum, its length is around 15 cm, and it's open into the, its lead into the anus by an opening called the anal opening, which length is about 2.5 cm. Next, the function of the large intestine. There are mainly three functions. Firstly, it helps in absorption of the water. Second one, it helps in formation, then temporary storage, and the removal of the various fecal matters, of the fecal matter, which is also called the food particles, and it is eliminated in the form of stool. Lastly, the colon bacteria that are present, it produces various important vitamins such as B12 and K, which are also required. That is why it is absorbed. The last portion is the anus. Last part is your anus. So the anus is the last part, or we can say it is the terminal part of the alimentary canal. We can say it is the terminal part or the last part of the alimentary canal. It is the last part or the terminal part of the alimentary canal. A good point, Rolero. NS bears two sphincter. One is the external sphincter, other is the internal sphincter. Anus bears two sphincters. External sphincter
एंड इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर.
स्फिंक्टर मैंने मुझे इट इज समहा ओपनिंग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर व्हिच कैन बी रेगुलेटेड जो दरकार हम सीटा ओपन हम ना तो सीटा कम्प्लीटली बंद हो. दी प्रकार आप स्फिंक्टर प्रेजेंट रहे एनएस रे वन इज द एक्सटर्नल अदर इज द इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर. इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर वेयर एज द एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर इज वॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर एंड इट क्लोजेस द एनएस कम्प्लीटली. इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर व्हेरएज एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर इज वॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर एंड क्लोजेस क्लोजेस द एनस कंप्लीटली. बुझिपारे द एनस बियर्स टू स्फिंक्टर वन इज योर इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर अदर वन इज योर एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर. इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर व्हिच रेक्टम लीड्स टू द इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर एंड ऑल्सो इट लीड्स टू द फाइनली इन टू द एनस बाय द एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर. द इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर वेयर इज द एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर मीन्स द एनस पोर्सन इज द वॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर एंड इज क्लोजेस द एनस कम्प्लीटली. मैंने जितेबाला दरकार से ओपन हे ना तो बंद हे. इट इज वॉल्यूंटरी मीन्स एनएस इज वॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर मैंने आम कंट्रोल अच्छी आम जितेबाला चाहे चाहिए से हिसाब से रेगुलेट हे कहीं इट इज वॉल्यूंटरी इन नेचर. बट इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी मैंने से आम कंट्रोल ना से आम अधीन ना. वॉल्यूंटरी इनवॉल्यूंटरी मैंने दुटा जिनस वॉल्यूंटरी मीन्स जोटा कि आम कंट्रोल अच्छी आम से कर. इनवॉल्यूंटरी मैंने जोटा आम कंट्रोल ना सब कमन एग्जांपल वॉल्यूंटरी मो हाथ मूवमेंट कर पाऊँ इट इज वॉल्यूंटरी किंतु हार्ट बीट हो इट इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी सेटा को मुझे कंट्रोल करें इट इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी किंतु हाथ को मूवमेंट कर पारि मो बॉडी पार्ट को मूवमेंट कर पारि इट इज वॉल्यूंटरी. सो दैट इज सो से भाया द इंटरनल स्फिंक्टर इज इनवॉल्यूंटरी नेचर वेयर एज द एक्सटर्नल स्फिंक्टर इज वॉल्यूंटरी नेचर एंड इट्स कंप्लीट्स द एनस एंड इट्स क्लोज द एनस कंप्लीटली. सो दिस वेयर दिस वन इज योर लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द एलिमेंट्री कैनल. So from the right, from the starting from the elementary canal, the first part, there were 8 parts we have discussed. Mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach. Today we have discussed in the previous class we have discussed the small intestine. Today we have discussed the large intestine and now we have discussed the anus. So these were the important main parts of the elementary canal. By which the digestion process takes place. These are the parts where the digestion process takes place. In the next class, we'll start our new portion, that is the associated glands, which also plays an eventual the most important role in the digestion of various food. But these are the associated glands. These where we were discussing the parts of the elementary canal. But now we'll discuss in our next class the associated glands, which eventually helps in digestion also. So this is all about your today's class. Apanko assignment rahila large intestine. Bro, pura apno likhibe large intestine ro introduction tikhe likhibe. Dita tinta portion cecum, colon ro types, rectum. Then rectum leads to the anus by the anal opening. Tar length kete. The function of the large intestine. Lastly, the anus. So etiki likhikina apan mote personally WhatsApp karibe. So in the next class we'll discuss the associated glands. So this is all about your today's class. Thank you.